गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन इकोनॉमिक बायोलॉजी बायो फर्टिलाइजर, व्हाट इज बायो फर्टिलाइजर? बायो फर्टिलाइजर और सब्सटेंस दैट कंटेन अ लिविंग माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म व्हिच व्हेन अप्लाइड टू सीड्स, प्लांट सरफेस और सॉयल, इट कॉलोनाइज द राइजोस्पियर दैट इज द रूट ऑफ द प्लांट और द इंटीरियर पार्ट ऑफ द प्लांट. And it promote the growth by increasing the supply of a primary nutrient to the host plant. Next slide, we can discuss about what are the types of biofertilizer. There are five types of biofertilizer. First one is rhizobium, second one is azospirillum, third one is acetobacter, fourth one is mycorrhizae, and fifth one is azolla. Here we discuss about rhizosphium. Rhizosphium, it is a soil bacterium that colonize the roots of a leguminous plant and it form root nodules. Rhizosphium is a nitrogen fixing bacteria and it fix the atmospheric nitrogen to the particular plant, that is the leguminous plant, and it convert them to ammonia. In this picture, we can see the plant root. In a root, we can see some of the nodules are presented in a root, and it also available in a powder form as a biofertilizer. Then we can see azospirillum. Azospirillum has the ability to use atmospheric nitrogen and it transport this nutrient to the crop plant. It is also inoculated on a maize, barley, oats and sorghum crops. It increases the productivity of cereals by 5-20% of millets by 30% and fodder by over 50%. It is the azospirillum bacteria. And it is a azospirillum biofertilizer. Then we move on to the acetobacter. Here we can see some of the application of acetobacter. Acetobacter has been found to increase the yield of wheat, rice, maize and sorghum. Apart from nitrogen fixation, these organisms are capable of producing antifungal and antibacterial compounds. It is an acetobacter biofertilizer and it is an acetobacter. Then we move on to mycorrhizae. It is a fungi. It have a symbiotic association with the roots of a vascular plant. It increases the uptake of phosphorus, for example citrus papaya. In this picture we can see the two plant root, isn't it? First one is there is no symbiotic association in this plant root, so it is called without mycorrhizae. Here there is some symbiotic association, so here the mycorrhizae filament fill the soil all around the root structure of this pine seedling. It is a mycorrhizae biofertilizer. Then we move on to azolla. What is azolla? It is a free floating aquatic ferent found on water surface having a cyanobacterial symbiotic association with anabina. It is a live floating nitrogen factory using energy from photosynthesis to fix atmospheric nitrogen. In this picture, we can see the azolla. Here, the paddy field is spread. Azolla is spread all around the paddy field. So here, the cyanobacterial symbiotic association has happened. Then we move on to the medicinal plant. The history of a medicinal plant is as old as the history of human beings. Most medicines are obtained either directly or indirectly from plants. All the major system of medicine such as Ayurveda, Yoga, Unnai, Siddha, Homeopathy, these are called Ayush. These drugs are obtained from plants and animals. These drugs from medicinal plants are called secondary metabolites. What is primary metabolites? It is produced by plant for their own living, for example, carbohydrates, amino acids, etc. And secondary metabolites is for production, competition and species interaction, for example, alkanoids, flavonoids, etc. Phytochemistry. It is a study of phytochemicals, which are a chemical substance derived from the various parts of the plant. Few plants derived drugs are described in. Here we can see the tulsi plant. Its botanical name is Oxymum scantum. Drug is essential oil. Leaves play an important role and it cure cold, fever, skin disease, etc. Next, we can see the catholic plant. Its botanical name is aloe vera. Drug anthraquinones. Which part is used to means a leaf spot is used to cure the heel wounds, skin disease, cancer, etc. This is a nilavembu plant. Its botanical name is Anthoharis paniculata and drug is terpenoids. All pods are used for medicinal purpose and it cure the dengue fever, diabetes, chikungunya. Last one is Nitya Kalyani plant. Its botanical name is Catharanthus roseus and drug is alkanoids. Here all pods are used. It cure the leukemia, cancer.